Hi everybody, welcome back once again to my channel called Dress Collection. And today's a series. I'm going to explain you some more of the sarees which I no longer wear it as a saree, but I converted into a different outfit. So it's a very comfortable outfits, and as I'm explaining you one by one, and also after explanation I'll be wearing it, and the photo you'll be seeing how elegant, how beautiful it looks. So in today's collection I'm going to show you a cotton sari, Kerala cotton sari. See, you can see that the Kerala cotton sari, there's not much of borders and all in this. Usually Kerala cotton sarees, nice simple plain off white, nice cotton, and it's a very good cotton. Usually Kerala cotton sarees are very good and very comfortable. The more you wash, the more the quality is much better. So this is Kerala cotton saree, which you can get it in most of the shops, or in Kerala shop exclusive you can get it, and it's not very costly also. So this has special borders. Usually Kerala cotton sarees have the special borders. So what I did, the saree, I have a few Kerala cotton sarees. So some of the sarees I got it converted into dress outfit. So this I got it again, high collar neck, nice high collar neck, little bit of design. You can see the design, little bit of simple design, and the border, some of the borders, what I did, the saree border, I put it in the middle so that it will come like this. Nice, it comes like this in the center, and it looks neat and tidy how I wanted it. I got it done, but it's your choice. You can adjust it anywhere, the borders. And then I put a simple two wooden type of buttons, extra accessories, so that it gives a better look. Simple one. And then again, it is I just put half sleeves. Usually I put three four sleeves, but I wanted this in half sleeves just for a variety. And then then I put an inner poplin cloth also, lining, cotton lining. And then again it is a high neck, and the whole complete border here I put it in the center, and also downwards again it is ankle length, and it is not below the ankle. Any of my clothes are not below the ankle, the outfits, it's above the ankle or till the ankle. And the sidewards is again, you can see a cloth attached to it so that it gives a nice flowy way. And the border, I got it done even here down so that it gives a better look. You can see the same saree border downwards also. So it's a very simple one. It looks very elegant when you wear it, and on some occasions you can wear this, and it's very comfortable in wearing. And then what I did, made this outfit, and also along with that the pallu also. Usually Kerala sarees, they have very simple border pallus. So what I did, the chunni, I made it, converted the pallu, I converted it into chunni. So you can see, very nice simple, just not too gaudy, simple pallus these are all, with nice dupatta. I made it as a dupatta with the same border and with the same, just the pallu portion I got it chunni done. Again, this is 2 meter 25 centimeter, comfortable, and this is very good cotton. So there is no like color going or any other problem with this cotton, with Kerala cotton sarees. And nowadays you get it in different colors also, and different paintings, and different like you get even more heavier border, zari border. You can see this border, kasav, they call it kasav sarees, kasav Kerala sarees. So the specialty of a kasav Kerala sarees, you have these borders here at the sides, and it looks very elegant. The pallu and or the this dupatta, it's looking very elegant. And when I wear it, when I show it into a photo, you'll understand how elegant it looks. So this is one of the outfits I wanted to exhibit. And then after this, I'll be showing another outfit. See, this is another saree which I converted into a dress outfit. This is another cotton, nice cotton saree, and I got it done and as a V, high collar V shape. It's your choice. If you want any design or any work here, you can get it done. But I did a little change. What I did, I got it frilled a little bit in the center, like this comes in the center portion, so it gives a better look. and if suppose if you wanted to put on the waist also, it's your choice, but I wanted it like this. So when you put pleats on this or when you frill it up little, so a little more cloth is required. So the sari I didn't waste it, I got it done, and also chunni also I got it done. So to explain you, see I got like this done, it looks prettier also for a variety of little bit change of your outfit. And then again it's a high collar neck and simple back is simple. You can wear it any season, as I explained you earlier also, any season. All my outfits can be worn any season. And then the complete the frills or the pleats are on the all the sides, all around the body. So this looks a better look. And also I got this done sleeveless. I didn't want any sleeves for this, for a variety. The sleeveless, so it's perfect for me. And otherwise it's your choice. And then again this is ankle length. It's not below the ankle, so you're free when you walk and all. Sometimes you can wear without chunni or you can wear with chunni. It's your choice. But this is nice free, a different type of outfit. And so after I explain you, like after showing you all the outfits, you will see in the photographs how wonderful it looks, how elegant it looks when you wear this type of dresses also. Along with this, it had got a very nice pallu. So I got the chunni, I got the pallu converted to chunni. Chunni is again 2 meters 25 centimeters. So you can see how beautiful the chunni, the pallu is. So this is the chunni. So no sari is wasted and no extra efforts. All in economically it is adjusted. So there's no much of expenses for all this. So see how nice it is. It's 2 meter 25 centimeter. So it's very comfortable in all seasons. If you want to drape it like this or you want it in pleats, it's your choice. Again, it has got an inner poplin lining, the dress. And the outfit is never transparent. Even though if it is cotton or if it is a garden, any sari, always, unless it is a very thick sari, there's no need of lining. Otherwise, inner lining poplin is very compulsory. So this is another outfit I wanted to explain. Then there's another outfit which I wanted to explain. Is made of another garden sari. See, this is another garden sari. This is Hakoba print. They call this print, this work as Hakoba work. So you can see how nice, simple embroidery, simple. It's like within the color. It's not like contrast or looks gaudy. Simple and very elegant color, and this color looks very decent also when you wear it. So again, it's high neck collar, it's high neck V shape, and also which has got a little collar on top. And then inner lining is again poplin cotton, and again it's ankle length and 3/4 sleeves. See the sleeves, the border of the sari I added to the sleeves, so it gives a better look. And also down portion, you can see at the ending portion also the border of the sari is there. So there's no much of, actually there's no wasting only of the sari. So there's no much of adjustments. It's easy to make. The tailor also was very, it's not difficult for them to make. And then the sidewards, again I attached an extra cloth which gives a nice wavy flow when you wear this and walk around. It is not a straight cut. It is nice wavy flow, but it doesn't touch the ground. And then the behind is again the same simple, which the border is just adjustment of the sari. It's all how you adjust your sari and get it stitched. So, and the sleeves is 3/4. It's your choice, whatever you want. And if you want any other shape of the neck, or you want to put strings attached to adjust your tightness or looseness of the dress, you can do so. But I felt it, this is good for me. So this is the dress. And along with this, there's a matching chunni also. I got it done with the same sari. This is the matching chunni. See, same plain matching chunni. It is a running sari, so there's no special pallu and all for this. So just the same sari. It's a matching running one. But what I did, I had an extra cloth with me, so I got the border, little thicker border of the corners, so that it gives a better look. Nothing else. It just gives a better look and looks nice. So instead of putting all the four sides, I just got it a little bit of the downer portion. In the breadth wise, I got it done. And also, the lengthwise, one side lengthwise, I got it done. Something to try out, which you have any extra cloth, you can add it like this, but not contrast and all that, because it looks gaudy then. So when you wear this, you'll see in the photo, when I wear this, you'll see in the photo, it is very elegant, decent, and whenever you have such light colors, you know, all colors will suit everybody. It's only how you make up your designs, and also never think that this color suits or doesn't suit, or anybody saying not suiting or suiting. You don't worry about all that. If you feel it is good for you, as all colors are very good for anybody, so just as how you make up your mind how to create it into different outfits, or and how you feel it comfortable. So it's all how you take it for yourself. So if all the color suits everybody, it's nothing like any color doesn't suit anybody or nothing like that. So this is one of the outfits. So anybody who has any light color sarees, you can convert it into this type of hakoba prints if you have, or you have any plain sarees also, you can put, you can do it like this, this type of outfits. So this is another outfit I wanted to explain. So this is another outfit which I wanted to explain. This is another saree. It's not garden saree, it's a party wear type saree. But since I took out the blouse, and that blouse is a little bit out of the this one, I'm not using that blouse anymore. So the saree is short for me. So what I did, some of the sarees when it's short, you cannot wear it much, you know. So what I did, this saree, I got it converted into this outfit. See how beautiful color is. So it has got very good embroidery on this. So you can see it is like small scales type, you know. So with the embroidery, you can see how beautiful it is. So this is, again, I got it done, another outfit. Again, it is a V high collar dress with inner lining poplin cloth. And also I got some of the borders in the middle here, the center, here above, here in the center. And also the design is good, like the embroidery is good, like different, you can see how the scales, different type beads and all this. So it was looking very nice, the saree, so I thought, well, let me convert it into dress, it will look much better. And then behind, again, high collar. Again, it's your choice, how you want to make any design here. And then little bit of change in the design, the borders and all, what it had, the saree, I got it done like this. Just one side, I didn't want on the other side, just for a look, different look on this side. Like you will feel like something different, and you will feel comfortable and nice, a different type of design. So, and then again, three-fourth simple, without any inner lining in the sleeves, okay. And then again, it is till ankle length, and then it's the same, it is again, extra cloth is added for a flowy type of dress, and very comfortable, and as you walk, it is very comfortable, it nicely, like a flowery flowy, it is nice flowing, and it doesn't touch the ground. See that your outfits do not touch the ground, so that otherwise it gets soiled or get dirty in any season, like it almost gets dirty, so unnecessarily, why to spoil that area. So all my outfits are till the ankle or little above the ankle, and you can wear any type of footwear, earrings, also chains, necklaces, up to your choice. That is your choice of accessories. So I wanted this in a very simple way, and it looks very elegant when you wear this. You will see it in the photo how wonderful it looks and how decent it looks. Some colors, some sari colors are beautiful, even though if it is plain with little bit of embroidery and little bit of work, but it looks very beautiful when you wear it. So along with this, I got even the chunni done, so you can see I didn't waste any cloth. Simple chunni. See, simple, same sari thing, but simple chunni. So with nice work, when you wear this and when you just drape it like this, you can see the whole, you can see in the photo also how nice the work can be seen. And it looks very elegant and very ideal, nice to wear in any season. Nice flowy, cooling, because you have the inner lining poplin cotton, so there is it's very comfortable for us, for anybody who wears such outfits. For me it is very easy to carry on. And then along like with this, you can, as I explained you can wear any of your accessories, whatever you desire. So this sari, so all these outfits which I'm explaining, like if you have any, I have any of like this type of plain saris, or which you have a little border and sometimes you would not know what to do, and when you don't wear such saris, so what I did, so what you can do, you can convert it into different outfits, and you can wear it in your daily wear. When you go out also casually, you can wear it and it will be very helpful to you. So these are some of the outfits, and afterwards in this show you will be also seeing the after wearing it in the photos, how elegant, how beautiful it looks. And it is very, very easy to carry on with such dresses, because it is free flowing and it is not till the foot, like it is not till it doesn't drag to the ground. And any season, if it is rainy, summer, winter, any season, it is very comfortable. You don't feel hot and all in this, very comfortable. So, and also, so I thank you all once again for taking out your precious time to watch all of my programs, all of my series, and also commenting on it, because which is very helpful for me in my journey of dress collection. And and different channels also go on, for Love Cooking is there and different channels are there. So I, for every all these channels, I thank you, each one of you, for your precious, taking out your precious time to watch all this, and to, and for liking it, and also giving me your comments for my betterment, and also for sharing and subscribing me. Thank you once again. God bless. Thank you.